locking our door for another adventure.
Hello adventurers, and welcome back to my channel. I have something super exciting planned today that Riley and I both have been looking forward to doing for quite some time. So today we're going to be going to eat at Pig and Pancake. I think you can see this place is pretty popular, so I actually had to get street parking, and Riley found a spot right up front. It looks like there is now another spot right up front that I could have parked in, but it's okay. We're in Astoria, it's gonna be a beautiful day, and Pig and Pancake, here we come. Now, Riley and I have been seeing Pig and Pancakes all up and down the Oregon coast, and so we decided this had to be on our Oregon bucket list as soon as we got back. So here we are, Astoria location. The menu is so cute. It matches what we see outside. This is gonna be epic. You can see here that they also have one in Seaside, Cannon Beach, Lincoln City, Newport, and Portland. And this is gonna be so neat. I love this. Look at the little pig with these little pancakes. Oh, it's so cute. But what's inside the menu? Oh my goodness. This is gonna be hard.
Hey, Riley.
Yeah.
We came here just a little bit after regular lunchtime, which I think was smart, but it's still packed.
It's still pretty packed, yeah.
So are you gonna lean toward lunch or breakfast more?
I don't know. Philly steak sandwich, probably lunch.
Ooh, I don't know what I'm gonna get yet, so I've gotta look through some menu real quick. This is gonna be everything. Okay, this is definitely happening in my life, I think. Either this or a soda, because I need some kind of caffeine this morning. Everything in my being says, get the cold brew, get the cold brew. Okay, so sure enough, I did get the nitro cold brew. I'm super excited. This is gonna give me just what I need today. And Riley agreed she needed some caffeine, so she ended up with a Mountain Dew. And look at the cute little pig.
What?
There's a pig. You haven't even seen the pig. Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh, I didn't even see the pig.
It's so cute. Boom. Drinks seem to be the easier thing to order because food is definitely hard right now. There are so many options. Let me show you some of those.
So because the time of day we're here, breakfast and lunch are both on the menu. So we could get any of these options, but they also have salads and sandwiches and burgers. And then over here they have some like combos and then the favorites. And inside here there's everything from like traditional favorites, like your pancakes and crepes, to something a little bit more interesting like razor clams and eggs, or Dungeness crab and cheese omelets.
Okay, I love that on the back of the menu, they actually have the story of Pig and Pancake, and it all began in 1961 when Bob and Marianne Poole opened the very first restaurant in Seaside. They only had $100 and $2,000 worth of borrowed equipment when they did it, and they managed to seat 35 people, but they were only open till about 2 o'clock. So it was a very short day, but their popularity began to grow and grow. And as it did, they expanded, they remodeled, and eventually turned into what we now know as Pig and Pancake with the 6 locations.
Now, Pig and Pancake is known for their specialty pancakes and breakfast options, but they also have the diverse menu that was so hard to choose from today. Now, ultimately, we are here around lunchtime, so we did decide to go ahead and choose something that was more of a lunch option, and I'm really excited about this. They do have a soup of the day, as well as clam chowder that is always on tap, so to speak. So Riley did decide that she was gonna try out some of the soup, but she's doing it with a burger. So she's going to be having what's called the Mr. Pig Burger, and I'm going to be having something a little bit different that I'm kind of fascinated by.
Right here they have this Southwest black bean burger that is roasted corn and smoky chipotle peppers. And so I was thinking that could be delightful. So I did decide to go ahead and do it in a more traditional way with the fries. So today we're gonna be trying the fries and the soup to give you kind of some feedback. And then Riley's burger right here, the Mr. Pig's burger, is an 8-ounce ground chuck with cheese on grilled French loaf. And you can actually have a choice of different cheeses in addition to all of your toppings. So I decided I was gonna try the Tillamook Pepper Jack, and Riley is trying the Tillamook Cheddar. So this should be really, really good. And just to kind of give you an idea, they are super fast, and already Riley's soup has been delivered to the table. Ooh, it smells good.
So now we just wait for our regular meal while Riley's getting her taste of deliciousness. And yeah, this should be fun.
What do you think, Riley?
This hits the spot. I didn't know that I had a spot to hit, but this is it.
It smells delicious, yeah. I will say that. Ooh, Riley's food is here. That looks delicious. Of course, Riley is super excited, but first things first, always first things first. And then I am also very excited. This is gonna be delightful. I did ask for my condiments to kind of be on the side, and I did cut the lettuce, tomato, and onion, but this is a black bean burger with the pepper jack cheese, and this is really big. This is super, super big. Oh, are you gonna be able to eat it? Are you gonna be able to eat it?
I don't know. It's such a funny shape.
It's so big.
Oh. Okay.
You didn't even get to the...
I didn't even get to the meat.
Okay, this is the most interesting bun shape ever, but is it delicious so far?
I mean...
The bread?
Bread veggies are good.
Yay! Okay, Riley's gonna keep eating, and eventually she'll get to the meat, and it'll be delightful, I'm sure. Ooh. Oh, I see that she definitely made some impact there. Okay, now it's my turn. Mine is a more traditional shape, so maybe this won't be as hard. I'm just gonna go straight into black bean burger. Mmm! Oh! That's very different. Definitely you can taste a little bit of the spice though. Very good. However, it does drip a little bit. This is a napkin situation. So, with that said, I'm going to get some ketchup so I can eat my fries. And I'm gonna continue in on this one. I can definitely taste a little bit of that heat that just resonates on the very front of your tongue. And it's very different than the traditional black bean burgers that I've had at other places. Now, my references are like smash burgers and places like that, where the black bean burger has a very distinct flavor that is traditional to them. But this has a very good flavor. Very different though. It definitely does remind me of some of the Southwest flavors that I love in Texas. Well, guys, as always, I lost with the food, so I'm taking it with me, but I did end up getting a nice coffee to go also so that I could take the cold brew, and then I have my leftovers for later.
Everything was super good, but I never can manage to eat a whole meal at lunchtime. I just can't. I don't know why. It's a lunchtime issue for me, but it was delightful. I will be eating the rest of it later, and I cannot wait.
Okay, so as we kind of wander around and look at the different things that are in here, you can see there's tons of seating. They do have all of the different bakery items, which look so delicious. And then also they have a little gift shop with some cute little things that you can pick up at Pig and Pancake. So that's kind of a fun thing. And part of the reason that they wanted to set it up in the way that they have, so they can have like a little gift shop option at every one of the Pig and Pancakes. So that's kind of cool. But I think that we're about ready to take our food and go. This has been a great experience. After seeing this thing pop up time and time again, I am so happy we finally stopped off at Pig and Pancake. The food was good, the service was amazing, and the story behind this place was so, so cool. Now, if you see places that continue to pop up, it's a sign, guys. You're supposed to go there. You need to try them out. And you might have an experience like we did. Remember, guys, we're not here for a long time, but we are here for a good time, and today was definitely that. I am leaving with my belly full, a to-go box to go back to the van, and more adventures ahead. Till next time, guys. Bye.